Namaste, beautiful yogis. Welcome to Yoga for Stress. We'll begin at the front of our mat. Coming in mountain pose. Feet pointing directly forward. You can have your big toes touching. Aligning the pelvis. Finding the proper place or alignment for the pelvis. Just feel it out. Pay attention to how you feel. Pay attention to how your alignment feels. Pay attention to your hips and their positioning. Pay attention to the balance of the hips and to both sides, the left and the right side, and see how they feel in relation to each other. This class will be also great for anxiety, depression. It is a class for fertility, which has been highly requested. And overall hormonal disbalance. Let's inhale the hands over the head, lift. Really lengthen. Exhale, diving forward. And just bring your hands either on the floor or on your shin bones, as far as your hands would reach down. And allow your body to be, upper body to be heavy here. Don't put too much effort into this. Don't force it. We're just now getting started. So just feel your back releasing the tension a little bit. Feel the neck releasing the tension. Feel the face muscle. Releasing the tension without forcing anything. Feel your belly letting go. Inhale, look ahead of you. Lengthen the spine. So here, this is another pelvic alignment pose. A lot of our hormonal issues come from misalignment in the pelvis. So here you can feel with the pull through the crown of the head, you can feel both sides, the connection of your upper body to your hips. You can feel your tailbone here aligning. Lengthen through the crown of the head. Don't yank your head up. Just look comfortably forward. Spread the fingers open and step in plank. Favorite plank. Even when I'm offering more relaxing classes, oftentimes you will still find plank in my classes because it is that important. And lower down, chaturanga, upward facing dog, chaturanga, downward facing dog. Spread the fingers wide open and just walk side to side here. Lifting through the tailbone. Again, bringing the attention to the tailbone, to the hips, to the shoulders. Exhaling tension and finding alignment. Inhale the right leg up. Step the right foot between the hands. Press the back heel away from you, stretching here. In the hip flexor, come up high lunge. Exhale down, plank, Chaturanga.
Upward dog.
Chaturanga, downward dog. Inhale the left leg up, step it through. Press the back heel away from you, come up. High lunge, and really align the hips forward, square them. Feel that hip flexor on the right side. Exhale down. Plank. Chaturanga, lower all the way onto your belly. Hands underneath the shoulders, elbows into your rib cage. Come up. Cobra. And exhale into down dog. Inhale the right leg up, step the right foot between the hands and come up. High lunge. Bring the left arm forward, right arm behind you. Grab your leg behind you with the right hand and twist here and reach over the head. Coming back up, clasping the hands, reaching to your right, so deepening that stretch. Exhale down. Plank. You can opt out for cobra here, or chaturanga, or double chaturanga. The choice is yours. Up dog or cobra. Second chaturanga, or straight back into down dog. Inhale the left leg up, step it through. Come up, high lunge. Reaching with the right hand forward, left hand behind you, twist. Inhale, coming up, clasping the hands and reaching over to your left. And exhale down, plank. Either lowering down in chaturanga or onto your belly. Up dog or cobra. And back. Chaturanga, down dog. Inhale the right leg up, step the right foot between the hands, drop the back knee down and come up, crescent. Coming back to your ujjayi breath. Let's bring both hands on the inside of your right foot. And hold here. And step it back. That's a hip releasing posture. Plank. Either cobra or up dog. And down dog. Inhale the left leg up, step it through. Drop the back knee down, come up, crescent. Really feel that hip. Exhale the hands on the inside. Walk the back knee a little further back. Keep your knee in. and step it back, plank. Releasing, rebalancing the hips. Moving through your vinyasa, either cobra or up dog. And back to downward dog. Inhale the right leg up. Step the right foot between the hands, drop the back knee down, and come up. Crescent, reach back. Let's bring the hands in prayer and bring the left elbow on the outside of the right knee. And coming out. Exhale, both hands on the inside of your right foot and walk the left knee back. We're deepening this pose. You can use this class as a way to work towards splits. The class has a few applications. Overall, I'm targeting the nervous system and the hormonal system, which makes it perfect for days when you're stressed out and you want to do something slower. Step it back, plank. Lower down onto your belly, cobra. Lower down, and before we go back to down dog, we're going to press back into child's pose. And let's come up, tuck your toes under, down dog. Take the left leg up, step it through, drop the back knee down, and come up. Crescent, reaching back. Hands in prayer, twist. Inhale, coming up. Exhale, hands on the inside of your left foot. Keep your knee in and deepen that stretch here. Breathe into your hip flexor. And coming out of this, plank, chaturanga, up dog, chaturanga, and down dog. Inhale the right leg up, step it through, drop the back knee down, walk it back. Come up, crescent. From here, make sure that the weight is falling on just above the kneecap on the left knee, not on the kneecap itself, Bring your left hand to your right knee and twist. Exhale, both hands on either side of your right foot and deepen here. Working towards splits, step back. It doesn't matter if you do splits or not. We're just stretching that area of the body. So you're working at your level. Wherever you feel the stretch, that's where you stay. But persistence pays off. Keep coming back to those classes and you'll be surprised how deeply your body can release and transform and shift and let go. Inhale the left leg up, step it through, drop the back heel down, come up, making sure that we're not placing the weight onto the kneecap, twist here, and bring both hands on either side of the left foot and press the back heel away from you. You might be very high here, or you might be a little lower. I would suggest don't force it, just take your time and feel the stretch. Although I could go in splits now, I'm on purpose holding back because I can feel levels of this stretch in different areas of my body. So that's a way to deepen the stretch. So stepping back, down dog, walking in place. Step to the front of the mat, exhale folding. And straight back, inhale. Come all the way up to standing, lifting over the head, arch, hands over the heart. From here, we're going to step the feet a little wider than hip width apart, just the way we step for squat. Toes pointing slightly out, and you're going to come down into yogic squat. So one more way to balance the hips and align the hips and the pelvis. This is great for your hormonal system, reproductive system, and this pose is great for fertility, great for pregnancy, because it strengthens the pelvic floor. But it's not just for women, it's for everybody. So you're using your elbows to open up the knees and feel how that releases your lower back as well. If you have lower back pain, this is the pose for you. You can let go of your prayer and take the right hand out and back, reach with the left arm up. Let's clasp them behind so that we can work a little bit on the release of the shoulders. And over to the opposite side. I don't know if Sophie is in the screenshot, but you can probably hear her. And opposite side, my dog. She is snoring as usual. And clasping, looking over the right shoulder. Release. Bring your hands behind you. Lower down into a seated, and here we are going to bring the hands by the hips for bolster pose. Optional, you can bring your back against the wall and just feel your alignment against the wall. in regards to your shoulders and hips, if you can place everything on the wall. Here, straighten out the back, open the chest, press the space between the collarbones open. The triceps are rotating back, or the outer arms are rotating back to open up the shoulders. Here you can feel a lot more of your alignment and alignment weaknesses, and this is a great way to balance out the spine and the pelvis. Chin parallel to the floor, press your toes back in towards you. Engage the legs. So now look down at your legs and see if one leg maybe is a little longer than the other, and try to balance the legs. See if that balances out your pelvis and your back. Pull the toes actively back in towards you. This is seemingly an easy pose. It's one of the challenging poses because it requires attention to detail. Excellent. Let's inhale the hands up and exhale forward bend. Inhale, coming out of it, straighten the back and hold here. Let's bring the hands behind us, reverse plank. Sit back down. One more time, inhale the hands over your head. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, coming up. And we're going to cross the feet and bring the hands in front of us, plank. Chaturanga. Up dog, chaturanga, down dog. Let's inhale the right leg up, step the right foot between the hands, drop the back heel down, and come up, warrior one. Hips are pressing forward. Open into warrior two. Take pliestins, since we are working on the hips. And let's bring the right arm forward, left arm up, cross them, interlace and reach up, opening the back of the shoulders. Unwrap and change, left arm under, reach up. Unwrap, reach over the head, side to side. Hands over the legs, again, pressing right hand into the right thigh, look over the left, changing. And let's bring the hands down on the floor. Knees down, calves parallel to each other. Flex your feet and lower down here. Great. Slowly walk your hands up, bring your knees a little closer together, sit back on your heels. Bring your knees slightly closer to each other, hands to the back of your mat. Take the right foot back, step the left foot to the front, warrior one. Open into warrior two. Plie one more time. Let's open the arms out to the sides, palms facing up. And we're gonna go for a few Kapalabhati breaths. Pumping the stomach rapidly, that relieves stress. So you can do this in general, on your own, whenever you feel very stressed out. It flushes toxic emotion out because it's a form of hyperventilation and that can really release stress after you're done. So you're pumping the stomach in and out and forcefully exhaling through your nose. I hope that made sense, and I'll demonstrate it now. Shall we do it one more time? Let's go, and don't be shy with breath work. Don't be shy, just go for it. Hands on the thighs. One more time, side to side stretch. Feel your spine. Let's bring the hands to the floor. Come into a seated, soles of the feet together. You can lean back at first. You can work on one side at a time, helping with your hands. Another pose that can help you with hormonal issues. I'll actually label this class also for PMS because it does have the essential poses for PMS. Everything is always related to stress. So plus that's for stress, it's for a wide range of conditions. And let's grab the feet and hold here, straighten the back. This pose is great for fertility for men as well for women. Release the pose slightly. Take a nice breath in and go again. From here, we're going to keep the left knee bent, extend the right leg in front of you, keep the foot in the upper thigh, reach up, exhale down. Inhale, reaching up, changing sides. Lift and exhale, forward bend. Inhale, coming up. Exhale, the hands behind you. Again, feet together, reverse plank. Release. From here, if you are doing this before bed and this is meant to prepare you for bed, you can skip to pigeon. And for the rest of us, we're going to do a few sun salutations. So you can scroll forward. If I remember, I'll put the time code for where pigeon starts, so you can go straight to pigeon and just skip the movement so that you can start winding down. Downward dog for the rest of us that are not going to bed. We're just looking to be relaxed. All right, walk your feet between your hands, exhale forward fold. Pay attention to the quality of your movement. Inhale, come up, exhale, hands over the heart. So I will take you through the first sun salute and then we'll do the rest with attention to the breath. With attention to the quality of the breath and the quality of the movement, paying attention to how your body feels and just being aware. Just being aware of your own body and of the sensations in your body. Feel free to do the sun salutes with your eyes closed. And let's inhale the hands over the head. Exhale, folding. Inhale, look ahead of you, lower down, plank, onto your belly, cobra, press back, down dog. Three breaths in here. Walk your feet to the front. Inhale, coming up to standing. Arch, hands over the heart. That was the first sun salute. Let's do 9 more so that we get into the groove of things. And I will keep quiet. and the end of the bend, you're going to lower your knees down and sit back in child's pose. Inhale your hands in front of you, and you're going to set up an alignment for headstand. You're either going to do full headstand or just half headstand. You can just walk your feet as close to you as you can and stay here, or you can even bring your knees into your chest and stay here, or you can take your legs up and stay here, press into your forearms so that you are putting as little pressure onto your head and neck as possible. And same way, lower down, child's pose. Inhale your hands over the head, coming into down dog. Take the right foot ahead, forward, pigeon. Here you can twist to one side, keep the hips square, twist to the opposite side, again hips square, lengthen, flex the foot, lower down. Coming up, Open the chest. Press back into down dog. Maybe draw a few circles with your knee. And let's take the left leg forward. Flexing the foot. Maybe stretch to one side, square the hips, opposite side. Lower down. And breathe. Relax. Coming up, open the chest, down dog, sit down onto your bum and round the back and slowly lower down. Laying down onto your back. Bring your left knee into your chest and just hold it here. You can draw a few circles. That again goes with the hip alignment, pelvic alignment. Opposite knee. Soles of the feet together. Extend your legs, bring the right knee in and stretch across. Supine twist. Give in to it. Opposite side. coming back up. Now, if you're going to bed, just keep your knees together and just lay here. Otherwise, you can do bridge. It may wake you up a little bit, so if you're going to bed, just keep it to be safe. Otherwise, you can go into either mild bridge or just a bridge with the hips as high as you can. Lower down, bring the right knee over the left, flex your feet and bring them in, stretching the hips one more time. Let's bring the left knee over, flex the feet. Bring the feet in towards you. Don't force anything yet. Feel the stretch all through your hips and glutes, possibly quadriceps, maybe even inner thighs, maybe even psoas. Let go of the right leg, bring the left leg up, keeping the hips square at first, keep them square, and just bring the leg across, picking up the psoas. Just bring it across, keep the hips square. You should feel a nice stretch here. Feel free to use a strap if you have a strap or a towel, or just your hand. Always the hand is your best prop. Opposite side. If you have any requests for props, let me know, such as bolsters and straps class. Opposite side. And release. Now for Shavasana, get to a wall, walk your booty as close to the wall as you can, and get your legs up onto a wall, palms of the hands up, relax your shoulders, soften the jaw, and stay here for a few moments. This is a really important pose, so I suggest if you are dealing with stress, anxiety, PMS, infertility and so forth, don't skip it. Stay here for a minute and feel the benefits. Let your legs or the femur drop back into the socket. The bone goes back into its socket and feel everything aligning, the pelvis aligning, everything just finding its place. Also a good pose for your heart since we're helping with circulation. Good pose for the spine because we're realigning the pelvis and the hips. Thanks for joining me today. Namaste.